want to jump out of airplanes?
Yeah.
It's pretty cool the first couple times, and then you have to jump out of the airplane with an 80-pound rucksack. The parachute weighs 40 pounds, and it's not an easy landing. You slam on the ground.
It only happened to you the one time.
Oh, I got you. This was right after Afghanistan, and I haven't jumped in probably 11 months, and it was my first jump. So, jump out. I remember coming down. I don't remember landing. I got drugged probably 50 meters on the drop zone, unconscious. I woke up in the FLA, and that is the medic's truck, and they were cutting off my blouse. They cut from here all the way up to here, up to here to check my vitals. I had no clue where I was, and I probably had symptoms up to a week later of dizziness and
Were you ROTC also, or did you?
Yeah, I did ROTC, Navy ROTC at Embry-Riddle, and it's in Daytona Beach. So ROTC, the good thing about ROTC is you still get like the military training. Like you have for the Navy, you do different summer trainings each summer. It's like the first summer you go on, it's called Quartermid. It's career orientation training for midshipmen. So you get to, it's 4 weeks long, and you spend a week with each of the different services. So I spent like a week on a nuclear submarine, I spent a week on a surface ship, I spent a week with the Navy Aviation Squadron, and I spent a week with the Marines, and that's when I landed in the Marines.
It's probably a school that not many people have heard about. Do you want to tell them what their special...
Embry-Riddle, it's like a kind of a specialized university. Obviously, it's an aeronautical university, so they specialize. They have all kind of flight training, so you can get all of like your civilian ratings there, and a lot of people go there that want to be like airline pilots, and they have like the one of the best aerospace engineering programs in the country. So it's kind of like, it's real specialized, and even like, they have like degrees you've never heard of, like airport management and like stuff like that. So it's pretty small, it's only like 4,000 people.
Talk about the process, like as far back as you can remember, as a high school student, when you made that decision in ROTC, who contacted you, and the process to get.
They're all freshmen. Yeah, so you guys still have time. If you think that's something you want to do, you really need to start thinking about it around 10th or 11th grade. If you're a senior and you're like, oh, I want to be ROTC, it's probably too late. So around 11th grade, you want to start looking at schools and seeing, oh, where do I want to go? And the application's online. It's pretty easy. I'll tell you all this because I didn't know it at the time. For the application for a Navy ROTC scholarship, there's literally a checkbox for like Navy or Marine because like, they're the same department, and that completely, like, once you're there, you can't switch. If you're like in the Navy, you're like, oh, I think I'd rather go be a Marine officer. They're like, no, you can't do that. So decide whether you want to be in the Navy Marines. You can put a list of like three schools you want to go to. And I mean, it's a great deal. The Navy paid $175,000 for my education. Like, it's a very expensive private school. Like, I would have never been able to afford going there ever if they weren't for the Navy. But because of that, since I'm a pilot now, after I get my wings in like a year or so, I owe them 8 years commitment, but I mean, they paid $175,000 for my education, and the flight training is worth several million dollars.
And you can do that with any of the branches, Army, yeah. Air Force, if you wanted Air Force, you can. But it's the same process, you just go on their website and fill out the application, you have to get recommendation, and you do it.
If you could do your life over, would you still make the same decision and take the same path?
Absolutely. I love my life.
Like you said, no.
No, for everything they just told you, that's for being an officer.
Yeah.
Completely different for him. He's
completely
like,
completely different. Me?
He can tell you we don't get training.
I don't, I would never want to be an officer, personally, because the work I do is actually like the grunt work on the ground, not sitting behind a desk and telling people what to do. I'm the one out there doing the work and guiding people under me and then getting told by people above me what to do and actually going out and doing it.
So you wouldn't do it again if you had?
No, I'm actually thinking about reenlisting. I don't know.
He just wouldn't be an officer.
Yeah, I wouldn't be an officer.
Mike, can you talk about your recruitment process and your decision? When you made the decision to enlist in that process working up through your basic training?
Yeah, I actually wanted to be a Marine whenever I was growing up. I went to the Marine recruiters my freshman, that was actually my sophomore year, and I talked to the Marine recruiters, and they just left a bad taste in my mouth. They had no jobs for me because I wanted to be infantry, and they wanted me to sign a blank contract, or not a blank contract, but a contract that didn't offer me a set job. So I told him I'd get back to him, and he kept calling me. He actually showed up at this high school looking for me once. So I talked to my buddy that I grew up with. He was in the Special Forces, and he led me towards the Army. So I got on the phone, called the recruiters, went in, and at this point I was a junior. I was 17 years old, and you can sign whenever you're 17 years old with parental consent, and that's what I did. I signed Airborne Infantry, and I just waited until I graduated, and 18 days, I left. And the reason why I joined is, like I said, I wanted to be in the service anyways, and I didn't think I was ready for college. I didn't really do well in school, and I wanted a career opportunity for myself, and the Army really offers a career opportunity.